Hey guys, it's Laura. Welcome to my channel. I am really excited. I've got a fun 12 by 12 traditional scrapbooking layout for you today, and I get really crafty in this layout. So I have this beautiful, beautiful paper here, and it's segmented into four different colors. And I don't really want to use that mustard yellow that's on the page. I'm making a summer layout, and to me, this mustard color is more for fall. So what I'm doing is I'm slicing that 1/4 out of the page, and I am taking this plastic bag that I have that is some packaging from a company. And I really love all the bright yellow daisies on it. To me, that color yellow is a lot more summery. So I am going to use that to fill in the 1/4 of the page that I just sliced out. So you'll see how I do that here. After I cut out that little segment, I use that as a template to cut out the same shape from the plastic packaging that I wanted to use. And then I also have a plain piece of white cardstock there that I'm going to layer that on top of and then cut that out. And then I am going to adhere the whole thing together. It's going to overlap a little bit, and that way it sticks really well using double-sided tape. So yeah, now the page to me looks a lot more summery with that bright yellow instead of the mustard, and I love those flowers there. And now that I'm thinking back on this page, I'm wondering why I went to all that work to put in that pretty daisy if I'm just gonna cover it up now. But I do just cover it up. So I have these two photos of me and my sister, and I have all these little paper scraps here, and I'm actually using my June Scrap My Stash kit for this. I made this layout back in June, and I realized I had a couple of layouts from June still that I hadn't shared. So this is using that kit, and all the supplies that I use in this layout are from that kit. So I'm layering down some different little patterned papers here and creating a really fun, messy photo mat for my two photos. And I'm going to use all sorts of colors, a lot of black and white. And I love these two photographs of my sister and I. We took them, we were all dressed up to go to church, and she was visiting me in Charlotte. She lives in Florida, and she really loves one of the churches in my local community. So every time she comes to town, we go to that church together. And it was a photo that I took of us in the car, or she took of us in the car on our way to church. So yeah, love that photo. Anytime I get to get photos with my sisters, it is one of my favorite things. So working on this photo mat here, you can see I'm using so many tiny strips of little patterned paper, and I love that. I love any time I can find a way to use the tiniest bit of pretty paper scraps. I don't like to waste any of it if I don't have to. And then I want to create a little bit of dimension there, so I fold up some of the edges of the little bits of patterned paper under my photo mat. And eventually I'm going to adhere all of this down to the page, but I'm taking my sweet time getting there. And now I am grabbing different embellishments that I think I might want to use on this page. I've got those pretty chipboard stickers. Those are from Crepe Paper Oasis. And if you watched my June Scrap My Stash challenge kit, you'll know that I was really trying to use up rubber embellishments, flare buttons, bows, and chipboard stickers. I had a ton of stuff pulled for that kit, and I used up almost everything I pulled for that kit. I was so proud of the progress I made and all of the scrapbooking pages that I made. So I pulled aside some of those chipboard pieces, and now I'm layering up different bits of embellishments from that kit that I think I can use on this page. And loving how it is looking so far. I love the flare buttons and those two little rubber embellishments there. I have got the little snow cone and that you and me heart, and then layering some chipboard throughout the page as well. I really love how messy that photo mat is. I think it is really pretty, and I love having some black and white on the right side of the page using those photo mats to kind of reflect all the black and white that's going on the left-hand side of that page with that quarter triangle there being all black and white. So I use my tiny attacher to attach my rubber embellishments, and I have to be really careful to put my rubber embellishments on top of something that it can be stapled to. I can't put it like in the middle of my scrapbooking page straight on the page because my tiny attacher can't go that deep. It's only got like a 3-inch clearance for you to stick some paper in there. So I put it on top of my photo mat, overlapping my photo mat. That way I can staple it to my photo mat. And yeah, now I'm grabbing my planner sticker book here that is also from that kit. And I use up a few stickers in this layout, actually quite a few. And I was excited for that too. I have a ton of planner stickers from Me and My Big Ideas. I've had a few happy planners, and unfortunately, I just can't get myself to stick with happy planning consistently. To me, I think like I just feel so bad using all that gorgeous stuff on something I know I'm going to throw away because I don't keep my planners. I do Project Life, I do traditional scrapbooking, and I do mini albums and stuff, so I don't need to keep yet another thing from throughout each year with me. I don't want to accumulate a ton of stuff. I just want, you know, my most important memories documented. So yeah, finding a way to actually use these planner stickers and to use them in a scrapbooking layout that I am going to keep forever, I love that because then it doesn't feel like I'm wasting them and I'm a-okay putting a ton of them down on one page because I know I'm going to look back at these layouts all throughout the years and my family will look at the layouts and my friends will look at the layouts and it will be worth having you used all those stickers on them. So yeah, you see I pile them up throughout the page. I'm using a lot of pink ones and I've got smiles, laugh, the girls, be brave, Sunday, and then I also put down one that says church. It was a good opportunity to use a ton of little planner stickers here. And then I am adding a doodly border around the edge of my page. And this is something that I picked up a few years ago from Ellie Edwards. I was doing December Daily in a traveler's notebook. I will link that down below. And I loved doing the doodly border throughout that traveler's notebook December Daily album thing that I did. But I hadn't tried it on a 12 by 12 layout before. And I saw Adele from Inky Quill on YouTube. She does this on her 8.5 by 11 scrapbooking layout pages. And I thought, I bet I could do that on my 12 by 12 pages. And I would love it just as much as I love it on my traveler's notebook pages. So yes, I call it a doodly border. It's just a hand-drawn black border there with a regular old pen or marker. And I call it a doodly border because that's what Adele calls it, and it is a catchy word or a catchy phrase. So yeah, as you can see, there's no real rhyme or reason. I'm just going over it several times around the page. It is messy. It overlaps in some parts. It kind of goes off the page in other parts, and that's okay. I like how it adds a handmade messy element to the page. Like you can tell that I'm the one who put it together because it is imperfect. And then I am adding a little bit of journaling here about how I love going to church with my sister when she's in town. And yeah, that's going to finish the page. Do I add sequins? I think I add sequins. Sorry, I filmed this all the way back in June and here it is August. I'm recording the voiceover and putting the video all together. I do add sequins to this page. They are clear, sparkly, and they end up looking a little bit like rhinestones on the camera, but they're a very clear color. And I love adding that little bit of bling to my scrapbook pages. I have enamel dots or sequins on a lot of the pages that I've made this year. I am super into sequins right now. I've always loved them, but now I am taking the extra effort to actually glue them down because these sequins are so tiny, they don't make glue dots that small. So I have to actually use my glue to adhere them down myself. And that's it. This is what the finished layout looks like. I really love it. I love the colors. I love the photographs. I love how it's a meaningful story that I'm going to want to remember in 20 years from now. And I love all the pink and summer vibes and all the really pretty products that I got to use up and get out of my stash and down onto a scrapbook page, because I don't want a beautiful craft room that's just full of pretty supplies. I actually want the memories documented. So in 20 years from now, I can look back at my scrapbooks and remember those important moments that I wanted to. That is what the memory keeping is all about for me, that creative outlet and a way to preserve the beautiful memories and, you know, even the sad ones and stuff, just having some documentation of my history. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of the fun layouts that I do, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye!